Morning. It's 5:30. Switch my torch off. It's still a little bit dark. It's not too bad. I got woken up by a fish, so thought you'd like to see the dawn first and then see the fish. Okay, let's get the fish out of the water.
Oh, early morning blog time or what? It's been a busy night, a really busy night. I like that it's going to be a busy morning and a busy day. This little fella's well lively, I tell you. He went all over the place. Not a bad fish too, but I need to get some water for him. Came off the middle rod, which again is the plateau. Seems to be the favourite spot. The rod on the bag to the left, that hasn't actually gone yet, which is off spot, but I'm expecting it to. But it's exactly the same spot almost all the time now, it seems. I also had a cat in the night of between 20 and 30 pounds. I didn't weigh it. Yeah. You're going to be a good boy, you're not, are you? Just trying to remember the weight of this fish now. I think it was 18 and a half pounds. No, it was 17 and a half pounds. Yeah. No, it wasn't. It was 18 and a half pounds. Yeah, it was 18 and a half too. 18 and a half pounds. Caught on a red berry boilie, as they all are at the moment. Stop using the goldfish, because it's so devastating with the cats. Not a bad fish. Not a bad fish to start the morning, eh? Log time, again. Well, the rod hadn't been out that long, middle rod, again, off the plateau. I got myself another one of these double figure mirrors. This one's 19 and a half pounds. So they're getting heavier. Let's get your best side, shall we, mate? You've got a scratch on that side, haven't you? You've got one on this side at all. There you go. There you be, good boy. There you go. A little bit lively. That's so big that I can't handle it. Lovely fish. Lovely brown orange coloured mirror. Oh, they don't want to be held up. Come on, look. Let's just show you to the people. Be good. There you go. So a couple of doubles for my early morning. I haven't had a coffee yet. I think I'm going to have one now though. I'll get that rod back out first though. Yeah, it might go off again. So there you are, couple of doubles for dawn. That'll do, won't it? Let's get the old girl back. Oh boy. They're generally both boys and girls with me, aren't they? Right. How about that for a sunrise? They're pretty spectacular here out in the fens. So that's a good start to the morning, eh? A couple of nice doubles. Well pleased. Big old slimy cat in the middle of the night. That one yesterday afternoon, late afternoon. So that's four runs. That's good. I'm well pleased. Kettle's on for my first coffee of the day. Wind's still coming from the northwest, so I don't have to move the bivvy this morning. I don't mind telling you, I'm actually quite knackered. Had a few blitz in the night, which I got up to. I suspect they were cats too. I had another run in the night, which I missed. Not a screamer, just a beep, 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 you know, one of those ones, which, you know, you decide to hit and hit, and I did. Nothing there. So I'm a bit knackered. So I'm hoping to get some kip today at some point, this afternoon probably, I don't know. What I need now is to supercharge myself with some coffee, and I've got some bacon with me as well as sausages this week, and eggs. So I think I might have a bacon roll. Well, we could do with some cloud. The sunshine is well out. I've got a feeling we ain't going to get any cloud. Got a few fish rolling. One to the right there, right on the spot that I had so much success off of in the swim to my right. A couple out in the middle here as well. And I heard them hoiking out last night as well. They do tend to.
I've got a floater out there on one of those little inline shock floats. I've been out over there trying for them as well. They completely ignored the flyer. They're not interested whatsoever. I didn't get anything off the zig at all. So it's pretty quiet really, unfortunately. Cooking up dinner at the moment. And that is chips. Well, round chips. Amazing. And sirloin steak. There's two there, both for me. Fortunately my mate Gary can't make it again due to other commitments.
He's having his house pulled down and something about surveyors and stuff like that. Anyway, so
I'm eating Gary's steak tonight, which was the smaller one anyway, so there you go. I'm sure I can manage two sirloin chunks. These chips are going to be ready in a few minutes. Put the lid back on. Make sure it's clean first. There you go.
The steaks will only need about 30 seconds each side, I reckon.
Well, that looks ready to me. Definitely.
Missing out, Gary.
Fish have just been cruising up and down all afternoon. They've been completely ignoring all the floaters that I've been putting out. They haven't touched any of them. I've been chasing them around with a controller and that, but to no avail. So I've settled in for the night session. Left-hand rod, middle rod, plateau and base of the plateau, right-hand rod. Back over there on the spot that I had a number of fish off of, it's there. So I put a marker float out from that swim to get the casting direction. Baited it with some red berry pellets and some boilies as well.
So hopefully I won't get a lot of sleep tonight. Night fishing's okay, but I do prefer to catch them during the day. It's much more fun, and sitting here all day, not idle, but it's a bit boring, you know. Hopefully when the water warms up a little bit more, we'll get a few more runs off the bottom during the day.
Well, we've just had a carp roll right over the swim, twice. Another carp roll just over there, go down bubble. So there's fish feeding in the area now, and I guess it's just hopefully how long it takes for them to find a hook bait and make a mistake. It would surprise me if it's the left hand rod again though. We've just had a carp roll over the right hand rod as well. So, sunset's bringing with it some action at last, which is what I expected.